Welcome back to the adventure. This is Adam, and today we're starting a new series on Microsoft BASIC, the Beginner's All-purpose Symbolic Instruction Code, otherwise known as BASIC, is a programming language. Like spoken language, there's a vocabulary and grammar. As we will explore in upcoming episodes, the vocabulary consists of fewer than 200 words, or keywords as we'll refer to them, and the grammar will be referred to as syntax. To get started, let's open QBasic. At first glance, QBasic looks like the edit program. There are some similarities between the two. QBasic does have some word processor features. However, QBasic is far more than a text editor. Let's start our first program. We'll need to begin with a line number. The traditional number to start with is 10. This isn't so much of a problem today, but in years past, editing a line number would require deleting an entire line of code. So if you needed to add something in between two lines of code, it was easiest to leave room between the line numbers. For line 10, we'll use CLS. Hey, that looks familiar. Clear screen. Yes, like how we use @echoOff in batch files, this is a good place to start when writing a program in BASIC. Next, we'll need the program to do something, so let's add another line number. Notice that the word print is capitalized for us after we press the Enter key. Print is a keyword, and QBasic checks the syntax for keywords and can make some minor corrections for us. The print statement is going to display the text in quotation marks on the screen. Last, we'll add the line for end. This will end the program. Now, let's try running the program. The words "Hello World" are shown in the upper left corner of the screen. While short and simple, this is a complete program. A line of code in BASIC is referred to as an instruction. BASIC understands two types of instructions. Those are statements and functions. Statements and functions look similar but serve different purposes. The statement does what you tell it to do when the program is run. The function returns information that you can use in your program. Let's take a closer look at the syntax for the print statement. Similar to how a command has parameters, a statement has arguments. The print statement has two arguments. These are the expression list and either a comma or a semicolon. The expression list is what gets displayed on the screen. In this case, "Hello World." You can also display a number with no quote marks. If we run the program, that's going to display the number 25. You can also enter an equation, like 2 plus 2. So if you run the program, we will get the result of 2 plus 2, which equals 4. Alternatively, we can use a function within the print statement, such as date $, and we can add another line of code here to print time $. And we could actually further add another print statement in here with no arguments defined. So now if we run this program, we get the date and time. This will display the current date and time when you run the program. As for the second argument the print statement understands, you can use a comma followed by another expression list item. This works like pressing the tab key. Or you can use a semicolon, which displays the expression list item next to each other. And that will look like this when we run the program. So at the top, we have the date followed by the time, as if you were to press the tab key. In the second example, we have the date and time all run together. And the print statement with no argument is just what's putting that blank line space in there. Right. That completes our look at the print statement.